Hi, this is the SensorLab. I will tell you how to develop a high-resolution optical encoder. The basic principles of linear and rotary optical encoders are the same, and the basic principles of reflective and transmissive optical encoders are also the same. I will explain step by step based on a transmissive rotary encoder. First, I will explain the mechanism structure for optical signal processing. An optical encoder comprises an LED light source, a disc, a reticle, and a photosensor. The disc and reticle are marked with areas where light can pass through and areas where light cannot pass. As the disc rotates, the light from the LED reaches the photosensor and then does not reach it repeatedly, and the encoder senses the rotation angle of the disc. The reticle is used to determine the sensing area of the photosensor according to the shape of the disc. Simply put, it is like a window opening and closing as the disc rotates. Let's enlarge the disc and reticle from the photosensor side. As the disc rotates, the open part of the reticle and the open part of the disc gradually match, allowing more light to pass through. When the open part is completely aligned, the most light comes in, and as the open part gradually decreases, less light passes through. The output voltage varies depending on the light reaching the photosensor. An optical encoder senses the precise rotation angle and direction of the disc using a voltage signal. To sense precise angles, the resolution of the encoder must be small. For this, the disc scales must be made dense. As shown in the figure, I will call the area transmitted through the disc scales a window. If the gap between the disc windows is narrow, interference occurs not only through the window facing the photosensor but also through the window next to it. First, as the light from the LED spreads out, more or less light than the designed amount may enter the photosensor. Second, if the LED and the disc are not assembled at a right angle, the light may enter at an angle, causing the amount of light to vary. Third, if the reticle and the photosensor are not assembled parallel to the disc, the amount of light may vary. If the scale gap is very narrow, the mechanical assembly of the LED, the disc, the reticle, and the photosensor must be very accurate. If the encoder is subject to external shock or vibration, it can easily become misaligned and malfunction. Generally, the scale pitch of the disc is tens to hundreds of micrometers. If you use a comparator, you may need to mark more than 30,000 windows on the disc to create an encoder with 17 bits or more. In reality, the disc scale is marked from 256 to 1024 windows per rotation and the analog signal is interpolated. Interpolation is a method of precisely calculating the angle between the windows by sensing the intensity of the light from the photosensor. I will tell you how to generate an analog signal that can be interpolated. The low-resolution encoder uses signal processing using a comparator. As the disc rotates, if the parts of the disc and reticle that the LED light can pass through match, the light will be transmitted and reach the photosensor. The disc windows and the reticle windows are made square. Two photosensors are used to sense the angle and rotation direction, and two signals, A phase and B phase, are output. When the disc and reticle intersect, if the marked shape is a square, the area where the light passes through increases and decreases linearly. As the amount of light increases and decreases in a triangle shape, the voltage output of the photosensors also increases and decreases in a triangle shape. This is a two-signal output that is one ratio interpolated by converting two A phase and B phase signals to a high signal if they are higher than the specified voltage and to a low signal if they are lower. Since the voltage waveform of the triangle changes discontinuously at the vertex, high-resolution interpolation cannot be performed. This time, I will tell you how to generate an analog signal that can be interpolated with high resolution. The windows of the disc are marked as squares and the windows of the reticle are as ovals. Two sine wave signals shifted by 90 degrees are output using two photosensors. One is a sine wave and the other is a cosine wave. At the two signals together, you can see a circle. When the disc moves by one pitch of the scale, the signal moves 360 degrees along the circle. High-resolution interpolation is possible for the following three reasons. First, the signal changes continuously along the circle. Second, the sum of the squares of the two signals, which is the radius of the circle, is constant regardless of the position of the circular signal. You can calculate the precise angle regardless of the amount of light. Third, since the ideal signal is circular, even if the analog signal is disturbed or distorted, you can calculate the precise position by compensating using the following equation. What is interpolation in an encoder? This is a hollow optical encoder with 2048 analog outputs. It is the process of generating a high-resolution position signal by dividing an analog signal into small angles. If you calculate the exact angle based on the circular signal, you can know the current position. This is a demonstration of 1x interpolation. In a one-cycle sine wave, the yellow signal rises at the zero position. The blue rises at 90 degrees, the yellow falls at 180 degrees, and the blue falls at 270 degrees. This demonstration increases the interpolation ratio in sequence, interpolates up to 16 times for a one-cycle analog signal, and outputs 64 counts. In 2x interpolation, the states of the two signals change to rising and falling every 45 degrees. In 4x interpolation, the states of the two signals change to rising and falling every 22.5 degrees. When interpolated 4x, the resolution is twice as precise as when interpolated twice. Let's calculate the resolution by interpolating 8x. The interpolator divides one cycle of an analog signal into 8x and outputs two incremental signals of 16,384 cycles per rotation. The encoder receiver counts the rising and falling edges of the two signals 4x per cycle. Since 2048 × 8 × 4 counts per rotation is 65,536 counts, the resolution is 0.0055 degrees. Let's interpolate 16 times. 2048 × 16 × 4 counts in one rotation, which is 131,072 counts, so the resolution is 0.0027 degrees. The old incremental encoder uses a comparator to convert an analog signal into a one-cycle incremental signal. In the same case, 2048 × 4 is 8,192 counts in one rotation, and the resolution is about 0.44 degrees. You can easily make a high-resolution encoder by changing the interpolation ratio without making many holes in the disk.
SensorLab.